All right.
Hi, so first off, I'm Ray. I'm the external VP for this year, and I'm a junior electrical and engineering major.
Hi, I'm Emily. I'm the third year CE major, and I'm your internal vice president for this year.
Hi, I'm Geffen. I'm a third year computer engineering major, and I'm the project manager, and I'm one of the project leads, and I got a haircut.
Hey everyone, I am Alex Rivera. I'm your hardware software project lead, and I'm a graduating EE this year.
Hello, I'm Ethan Sifferman. I am a third year computer engineering major, and I'm a project lead.
Hi, I'm Daniel. I'm the NatCar lead this year. I'm a sophomore EE.
Hey guys, I'm
Nano.
I'm a fourth year EE. I'm the lab manager, Rip the lab, and my camera's off right now.
Is Owen here?
Owen is my assistant lab manager, and he is not here from the sounds of it, but that's okay.
Hello, I'm Luke. I'm a second year electrical engineering major, and I'm the publicity chair for this year.
Hi, I'm Calvin. I'm a third year CE and I'm the social director for this year.
Hello, I'm Kelly. I'm a second year EE major and I'm the treasurer this year.
And Andrew Liu, our president, unfortunately also could not make it today, but he's here in spirit.
All right, let's move on to the lab. Nano, would you like to talk about the lab?
Yeah, so normally the lab would have pretty much all tools you need available, such as solder, ink stations, oscilloscopes, resistors, and whatnot. We also have a 3D printer, which Alex is very experienced in. But unfortunately, due to pandemic, there is no lab right now. But here's all the information. It's located in trailer 699, and hopefully we can open it up at some point. You guys can get in there and have some fun with it.
All right, so we have two things new this quarter. One is a very special LiDAR tech talk by a representative from Continental. Continental is also located in SB, and so, you know, potential internships. But yeah, we're pretty excited to get this like exclusive tech talk about LiDAR. I'm personally pretty interested, and I think some of our other officers are interested as well. So yeah, come on if you can. Another event we have is a social event. We're like in the works of trying to come up with some kind of game night. You might also collab with a different organization. And so, yeah, just heads up about that. And, you know, a major part of this club is the projects that we offer. We have three different kinds of projects. One is like a personal slash group projects. Another one is a club project. And the last one is our guided projects. And this quarter, just like last quarter, we have the same guided projects, and our project leads will talk about them. So how our guided projects work is that in each class, you'll just week by week try to build your respective project with the help of the project lead. You know, they will be there to guide you when you have any issues. And so, you know, every week there's gonna be like a class you'll attend, and then the project lead will, you know, try to just guide you with the concepts and help you build a project.
Hey everyone, I'm Alex again, and I'll be talking a bit more about my project. So this project is for those of you who are joining us for the first time this year. It's our hardware software project, and what it is it's a persistence of vision display, and you can see it's kind of like a glorified fan blade with some LEDs on it. So it spins around and it shows text. It's Arduino based. And what kind of my target audience would be some people who obviously have some hardware and software design, some people who are trying to get deeper into the coding of microcontrollers, and those who want to do through-hole and surface mount program or soldering. And another thing I teach in this class is how to design PCBs. So I go through the rundown on how I designed this PCB, just a real like in-depth. We spend two classes doing it. And some changes this year is I will be providing only the 3D printed parts and the circuit board. Last quarter I did provide everything, but I was unfortunately paying out of pocket. So I do make some changes this quarter. And another thing is you will need a soldering station this quarter if you wanted to join this project. We'll be sending out some sign up emails later on this week, I'm sure. This second slide is it goes over the curriculum, and it shows a little picture of it working. So thanks, guys. I look forward to meeting all you guys.
All right. Thanks, Alex.
Hey, everyone. So this year's hardware project will basically just teach you how to build something called an analog step sequencer, which is just like a simple musical device that can play a melody by just basically playing a sequence of 8 tones. And we'll show the demo in a second. But if you could go to the next points. Yeah. So I mean, in general, like there's no prerequisites. So I guess in general, I should just say there's not really any prerequisites to our projects, right? They're open to any skill level. So it's just depending on what your interests are. But the target audience for, if you're trying to figure out, you know, what project you want to build, this project is purely hardware. There's no software. And it's mainly dealing with, I guess, like analog circuit concepts. We talk a little bit about sound synthesis and just working with hardware and electronics in general. So if that's what you're interested in, and we'll basically be building everything from scratch. So we'll purchase the electronic components. I'll introduce, you know, how to use the like discrete components like resistors, capacitors, and such. And then I'll also talk about integrated circuits. And then, you know, by the end of it, we'll have a fully working project. So this is like the demo. It basically just plays a little tone at every LED flash. And what I'm doing basically is just turning the potentiometers to have a different frequency button.
Cool. Thanks, Geffen.
Hello. So my project is going to be on binary hacking. So I forgot to change the previous slide. It still said web development. That was last quarter. But this quarter, yeah, it's going to be all about binary hacking. And really it's about like binary data, because most of the time, like we're familiar with editing text, and you open like a text file like .txt, and we know how to edit that. Like if there's some words, it's really easy to just go and change the text, but it's way harder to change binary data. So this class, we will be creating our own Super Mario Brothers hack. And we are also going to be making our own WAV file parser, and WAV files are used for storing music data. This class is mainly targeted for those who are interested in how binary data is actually stored and also understanding file formats, meaning like more on like how binary data is stored specific to each like different type of file. Or if you just really want to make a Mario game, or if you are really interested in music. And so I have a quick demo. If I could get screen sharing
privilege. Yeah.
Awesome. All right, can you see this screen? Can you see my mouse?
Yep, yeah.
Okay, cool. So so one thing I would always do when I was younger is I would open up files with like the wrong program and see what would happen. So like here's sample.wav, and if you open it in Notepad, you get all this garbage, and there seems to be no way that you can make any sense out of it. However, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be making sense out of this and actually figuring out what all of this data actually means. And to me, that just like blew my mind. That would blow my mind if I was doing this as a kid. And so here I have Super Mario Brothers, and this is the default game, what it normally looks like. I can play it. And you can see a Goomba. But then, so what I did is I edited the file, the binary data, and now it says SV IEEE Bros, and then I can play this. And now the Goombas are replaced with ghosts from Pac-Man. And up here, you can see my name. So if that looks interesting to you, you should do my project.
All right, so up next, you've heard about our three guided projects, and we'll be talking about NatCar next, which is another team project.
Yeah, so NatCar is a group project where we're basically trying to build a little like RC scale cars, a little picture of it in the top right there. That's supposed to autonomously follow a white tape line on the floor. And it's a competition between the different UCs hosted by UC Davis. Now, obviously, we're not going to have a competition in May this year. So since we can't really physically work on the car, also be focusing more on the software side of things and possibly trying to simulate the car, like make a little so we can test our software. There's a little bit of work to do on the electronics because we have to make a motor driver and a few things like that. But that's more difficult to work on remotely. So anyway. But on the software side, we're going to be using a little camera on a stick. So that's what's on that yellow or on that that white triangle thing on the front of the car. And then with those images from the camera, we're going to use write some code in C++ using the OpenCV computer vision library to identify the line, possibly remember the line, and then figure out how to drive the car, you know, the steering and throttle, based on that information. And we might do some CUDA GPU acceleration if we need to. Not sure about that yet, but anyway. So if working on any of that or learning about stuff like that sounds interesting, email me or contact me over Discord. And I can get you caught up on what we've worked on so far, because we have been working on this since fall and before. So yeah.
Cool, thanks. So then next we're gonna talk about our website, which is like the main hub for all the information that you've seen here and other updates throughout the quarter. So all the resources that you would need are on the website. Project website, so all the information about the projects and all the notes from their classes in case you miss one and wanna stay caught up will be on the website under the projects tab. Also the gallery, which has pictures of like all the stuff that we'll be doing. There's an event calendar, so you can check back to see when the workshops are happening, when the project classes and office hours are happening, as well as the potential events that we'll be having later in the quarter. We also do a resume book, which basically is like, you can upload your resume and it goes on this big list that we send out to companies. I'm not sure how that's working this quarter, but we'll be sending out updates about how you can participate in that. And normally the website would also have a lab checker, which you can just open the website and see whether somebody was in the lab. But unfortunately, obviously this quarter, things are a little different, but eventually that'll be back working and you'll be able to see whether there's somebody in the lab just from the website. So that's the main thing. Also, it has all of our contact information. So if you need anything from an officer, you can find it there under the resources tab. All right, and then a big announcement. This is one big thing that we're doing differently from last quarter is how we're selling our merch. So y'all have probably seen those ECE hoodies. And if you're wondering how to get one, even if you're not on campus, there's a way now. So we're partnering with the Engineering Student Council this quarter and probably next quarter as well to be selling these online. So if you go to that link, you'll be able to order the hoodies and the t-shirts from ESC, and we'll still get some of the proceeds. So definitely hit them up and they'll ship straight to you no matter where you are. Hopefully, I think maybe within the US, but I'm not really sure. So that's one fun new thing for this quarter. So in sum, we're not gonna have any membership fees. The projects will probably, there might be a fee for the parts that you need for each of the hardware projects, but in general, there won't be like a membership fee for attending the workshops or anything like that. So we'll have that Continental Tech Talk and potentially social events later in the quarter. And then we have those three guided projects, the analog step sequencer, the binary hacking, the persistence of vision display, and then the NatCar project as well. And we've got our merch available on the website. And so we'll be sending out an email probably later this week as a follow-up with signups for the projects and also all the information that you've had here in a summary. You can also find all of that information on our website. So next slide. All right, so here's a little video that we've got.
Hopefully that cool video makes you more interested in joining Actual League.
Yeah, so actually all those projects in the video were things made by IEEE officers. So if it interests you, you can talk to any of us and we'll let you know how to get involved in the stuff that we've shown you. This is all our contact information. Definitely follow up if you have any questions about the projects, but we'll also be in touch after this. Joining our email list is probably the best way to stay in contact with us, but you can also join the Facebook group, also Instagram, and the Discord server is pretty active with announcements and stuff. So definitely check out all of those or whatever medium is your preference. And thank you all for coming. If you have any questions, you can ask now. I'm gonna stop the recording.